I love her. I love her very much. I've never had a feeling like
this. Shut up. Young lady, you don't fool me one bit.
I'm not trying to. But I bet I could, though.
No, you might convince this jackass that you love him, but you'll never convince me.
That's too bad, because I do love him.
Certainly. For his money?
No, honestly.
Have you got the nerve to stand there and expect me to believe that you don't want to marry my son for his money?
It's true.
Then what do you want to marry him for?
I want to marry him for your money.
Fair. I want you to put this in a safe place.
What is it?
A letter of credit.
Oh, that's real sweet. You started writing me even before I went away.
No, dear. You see, a letter of credit is like money.
Money?
Yes. Just take it to a bank in Paris when you get there.
Oh, that's wonderful. Be sure and write me every day. I'll be so lonesome.
I bought you a little going away present, dear.
Daddy. Sometimes I think there's only one of you in the whole wide world.
I like a man who can run faster than I can.
I hate to think where you'll wind up. You're wasting all your time on unrefined persons without any money.
Honey, did it ever occur to you that some people just don't care about money?
Please, don't be silly. We're talking serious. You don't want to end up with a loveless marriage, do you?
Me? Loveless?
That's right. Because if a girl's spending all of her time worrying about the money she doesn't have, how is she going to have any time for being in love? I want you to find happiness and stop having fun.
That baffles me.
Mr. Esmond!
Is it the right size?
Oh, they can never be too big. Do you think it's too small, Dorothy?
Looks like it ought to have a highball around it.
I mean, does it fit your finger?
Oh, yes, it fits perfect. Daddy, I bet you made me the happiest girl in the world.
I don't know what you do, honey. Unless you use Novocaine in your lipstick.
Daddy.
Huh?
She'd have to be a pretty terrible girl to be mean to a sweet, intelligent, generous man like you, Piggy.
My dear, you must let me do something for you to show my gratitude.
Oh, thank you ever so.
May I kiss your hand?
I always say a kiss on the hand might feel very good, but a diamond tiara lasts forever.
A diamond tiara?
Yes, Lady Beekman's. I just love to have it.
Good gracious.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. But wouldn't you rather have some furs or a racehorse or a motorboat?
No, thank you.
Well, it would be very difficult for me to explain to Lady Beekman that I'd given away her jewels.
But you're so clever, Piggy. You could if you put your mind to it.
Do you really think so?
Of course I do. And besides, it's only fair I should have her tiara. Because after all, she has you.
My dear, my very dear.
Oh, Lorelei.
Don't you see that's why we have to have his consent, silly?
Well, at least we're getting down to brass tacks. You admit that all you're after is money.
No, I don't. Aren't you funny? Don't you know that a man being rich is like a girl being pretty? You might not marry a girl just because she's pretty. But my goodness, doesn't it help? And if you had a daughter, wouldn't you rather she didn't marry a poor man?
But I was...
You'd want her to have the most wonderful things in the world and to be very happy. Oh, why is it wrong for me to want those things?
Well...